الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. Whoever says that the Shia or the Rafida are brothers and sisters in Islam had better take a look at themselves and had better return back to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best people is of my generation, then those who follow them, and then those who follow them. And when we look at the creed and the madhab or minhaj of the Salaf al-Salih, the methodology and understanding Islam, we'll find that there was no cooperation between Ahl al-Sunnah and the Shia, especially those extremists who cursed the beloved Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman and make takfir of them, consider them disbelievers. How is it possible that a Muslim in this day and age, if they have any knowledge of Islam, now that's assuming that they have knowledge, could say such a thing? Most of the people who say these kind of statements are in fact very jahil, they're very ignorant. They're usually from the general Muslims who haven't studied much of Kitabillah, ولا سنة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا فهم السلف الصالح. They're usually far away from knowledge. This is why they would utter such a statement that the Shia are our brothers, the Rafida especially. How could you possibly think such a thing? And some of our brothers and sisters become confused in this affair, that they become they're wondering, they're saying, hey, these guys, the guy said la ilaha illallah, he prays in the masjid, even though he prays with a rag or a towel or a rock or a stone in the masjid, and he prays after our jama'ah, he's still our brother. Why? What's the big deal? He says Shia, I say Sunni. We drink coffee together. We go to lunch together. We date together. وَعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. But in fact, brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to go back as Imam Malik, or it was Imam Shafi'i, one of those great imams of Ahl Sunnah. They uttered the statement, they said that this ummah would not be rectified except for what rectified the first of the ummah. Meaning that if we don't return to Kitabillah, wa sunnat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa fahm salaf al-salih, we will have no success. We'll remain in the state that we're in, divided, have an enmity towards one another. And people who worship graves and say they're Muslims, they say la ilaha illallah, but in fact they go to the graves and they worship the saints, similar to the Catholics. And then we have another group of people who say la ilaha illallah, they turn off the lights and they make dhikr until slobber comes out of their mouth. And some of them reach to the level and say that they have become Allah, or they're one with Allah, and they no longer have to worship Allah. They no longer have to do the duties of Islam. Then we have another group of individuals who claim La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. However, this group, what do? They curse the people who preserve the religion of Islam. That min fadlillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved the religion through these men and women. These great people who sacrificed their wealth, their property, and lives for Islam so that you and I would be able to utter the kalimat al-tawheed. And you and I would be able to understand the kalimat al-tawheed. And you and I would be able to practice the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of us left kufr to come to Islam, to come to the light of Islam. But then some of us left other religions and we entered into that belief, the belief of the Shia, the belief of those people who curse our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. How can they be successful? How are these people on any kind of madhab that could be understood or associated with Islam? We would prefer it if you just called yourself whatever you want to call yourself, but don't associate with Islam, saying that you have imams, Imam Khomeini, Imam Fulaniya, Imam Fulan. These people are on Dalal and they call people to kufr wa shirk wa zandaka. They call people to worship themselves, the Tawaghit. And Allah sent all the messengers alayhim after salatu wa salam with the message of Tawheed only. Worship Allah alone, not your imams. Your imams are not infallible. And stay away from those imams of Dalal. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says? وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا إِنْ نَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. We have sent to every nation a messenger to worship Allah alone and stay away from the taghut. Ibn al-Qayyim said, the taghut are who? There are those people who call to worship in themselves. There are those people who call, who rule by other than what Allah has revealed. Those are some of the tawaghit. Those people. So those people who call you to worship them and say, hey, our imam doesn't have to pray anymore. He's become one with Allah. And they use the ayat, حَتَّ بَلَغَ الْيَقِينَ. Well, Ahl al-Sunnah understands this ayat, that until they meet certainty. Certainty here means death, if you go back to the tafsir. But if you go to their tafsir, they believe they no longer have to practice the sharia. They've gone beyond it. They've become one with Allah. Or they're so close to Allah, that, and they're such a wali, that they no longer have to practice. A'udhu billah. Which one of you are awliya stronger than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who is closer to Allah than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Didn't he pray? Didn't he stand in the last third of the night until his feet were swollen? Didn't he make istighfar akthar min 100 marat biyum kama qala nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Didn't he make istighfar? He seek repentance and forgiveness from Allah more than 100 times a day? This is one of the ahadith. This is mentioned in the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So I ask all of those people who say that the Shia are our brothers to make tawbah and move away from this innovated ittiqad jadeed and this dalal mubeen and come back to kitabillah wa sunnah rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I ask that Allah guide all the Shia to come into the fold of Islam and worship Allah alone and make our numbers big, worshiping Allah, calling people to Allah and leaving that behind in khair. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.